Hi all, I am Dr. Deepa, Associate Professor in IT, Sri Ramakrishna College of Arts and Science, Coimbatore. In this session, we will discuss about cluster analysis in data mining. We will discuss what cluster is, its various application and various method used in it, and then we will conclude. Now let us see what a cluster is. A cluster is a subset of similar object, a subset of object such that the distance between any of the two objects in the cluster is less than the distance between any object in the cluster and any object that is not located inside it. Look at the figure. You can see a group of various shapes in different colors like red, yellow, green, purple, etc. and on the left, and similar shapes grouped together in the right. Here, red color triangles group as a subset of object shapes. Now let us see what is clustering in data mining. Clustering is a method of converting a group of abstract objects into classes of similar objects, or clustering is a method of partitioning a set of data or objects into a set of significant subclasses called clusters. So what is cluster analysis? It is finding group of objects such that objects in a group will be like one another and different from the objects in another group. Now, applications of cluster analysis. Cluster analysis is used in many applications such as market research, pattern recognition, data analysis, and image processing. It assists marketers to find different groups in their customer based on purchasing patterns and can categorize their customer groups. It helps in classifying documents on the web for information discovery. Clustering is used in outlier detection application such as detection of credit card fraud. As a data mining function, cluster analysis serves as a tool to gain insight into the distribution of data to analyze the characteristics of each cluster. It can be used to determine plant and animal taxonomies, categorization of genes with the similar functionalities, and gain insight into structure inherent to populations. It helps in identification of areas of similar land that are used in an earth observation database and in identification of geographical location. Now we will see why clustering in data mining. Based on the above application, let us see the significant features required for various clustering methods in data mining. The features required are 1. Scalability. We need highly scalable clustering algorithms to deal with large database. Interpretability. The output of clustering algorithm should be interpretable, comprehensible, and usable. Discovery of clusters with attribute shape. The clustering algorithm should be capable of detecting clusters of arbitrary shape. That is, they should not be bounded by distance measures that tend to find spherical clusters of small sizes. Ability to deal with different type of attributes. Clustering algorithms should be capable of being applied to any kind of data such as interval-based data, categorical and binary data. Ability to deal with noisy data. Databases may contain noisy, missing or erroneous data. Some algorithms are sensitive to such data and may lead to poor quality clusters. High dimensionality. The clustering tools should be able to handle high dimensional data space and also low dimensional space. Now we see various clustering methods based on the features of application. Clustering methods can be classified into following categories. First one, hierarchical method. This method will create a hierarchical decomposition of a given set of data object. Based on it, we can classify hierarchical method as follows. 1. Agglomerative approach. 2. Divisive approach. Agglomerative approach is also known as bottom-up approach. Here we begin with every object that constitutes a separate group. It constitutes to fuse objects or groups close together. 2. Divisive approach. It is also known as top-down approach. We begin with all the objects in the same cluster. This method is rigid. It can never be undone once a fusion or division is completed. Next, partitioning. In this approach, several partitions are created and then evaluated based on given criteria. Accordingly, it's divided into 1K means to exception maximization. Suppose we are given a database of n object and the partitioning method constructs K partition of data. Each partition will represent a cluster of K less than or equal to n. It means that it will classify the data into K groups and it need to satisfy the following requirement. Each group contains at least one object. Each object must belong to exactly one group. Next is density method. These algorithms produce clusters in a determined location based on the high density of data set participant. It aggregates some range notation for group members in clusters to a density standard level. Such processes can perform less in detecting the group surface areas. Grid-based method. Grid-based method work in the object space instead of dividing the data into a grid. Grid is divided based on characteristics of the data. By using this method, non-numeric data is easy to manage. Data order does not affect the partitioning of the grid. Model-based. This method uses a hypothesized model based on popularity distribution. By clustering the density function, this method locates the clusters. It reflects the data points' spatial distributions. In this session, we have discussed in brief what clustering in data mining is, its various applications and methods used for it. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you.